the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We continue our journey through ordinary time. We open our hearts and our minds to take in the Word, to allow those words to sink internally, to draw out the very best of God's love for us, so that we can't help but be transformed, to become something more, to become something new, to allow us to move closer and closer to who God wants us to be. But we know that there are moments in our life where that is difficult. Sometimes it's very challenging to really find God's will, to stay on God's will. So let's recall some of those times where we have rejected God's will, we've rejected that love of God, and ask for pardon and for peace.
Lord Jesus, you sustain us with the word of life. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, your word is salvation for all who look to you in hope. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, your word is justice for all who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins and lead us to everlasting life. And together let us say, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty and sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed Cyrus, whose right hand I grasp, subduing nations for him and making kings run in his services, opening doors before him, leaving the gates unbarred, for the sake of Jacob, my servant of Israel, my chosen one. I have called you by name, giving you a title. Through you knew me not. I am the Lord, and there is no other. There is no God besides me. It is I who arm you, though you know me not, to toward the rising and the settling of the sun. People may know that there is no one besides me. I am the Lord, there is no other. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the Lord, all you lands. Tell his glory among the nations. among all peoples his wondrous deeds.
Give the Lord glory and honor.
For great is the Lord, and highly to be praised. Awesome is he beyond all the gods. For all the gods of the nations are things of naught, but the Lord made the heavens.
Give the Lord glory and honor.
Give to the Lord, you families of nations. Give to the Lord glory and praise. Give to the Lord the glory due his name. Bring gifts and enter his courts.
Give the Lord glory and honor.
Worship the Lord in holy attire. Tremble before him, all the earth. Say among the nations, the Lord is king. He governs the peoples with equity.
Give the Lord glory and
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the theologians. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the Church of the Theologians, and God the Father and Lord Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace. We give thanks to God always for all of you, remembering you in our prayers, unceasingly calling to mind your work of faith and labor of love, and endurance in hope of our Lord Jesus Christ, before our God and Father, knowing, brothers and sisters, loved by God, you were chosen. For our gospel did not come to you in word alone, but also in the power and the Holy Spirit, with so much conviction. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shine like lights in the world as you hold on to the word of life.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The Pharisees went off and plotted how they might entrap Jesus in speech. They sent their disciples to him with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. And you are not concerned with anyone's opinion, for you do not regard a person's status. Tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not?" Knowing their malice, Jesus said, "Why are you testing me, you hypocrites? Show me the coin that pays the census tax." Then they handed him the Roman coin. He said to them, "Who "Whose image is on this and whose inscription?" They replied, "Caesar's." At that he said to them, "Then repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." The Gospel of the Lord.
So I forget where I heard this, but it's been very true, and it's proven itself to be very true the more I've started to kind of pay attention to this. Truth usually comes after a but, doesn't it? Oh, you're great. Oh, you're wonderful. Oh, you're this, this, this. But add the pieces. The front part, to use the language of my students, kind of gas us up a little bit, gets us excited. Ooh, oh, you think I'm good. Oh, you think I'm this. Oh, you think I'm that. Oh, okay. It softens the blow a little bit. Or a favorite, with all respect, add the pieces. Oh, well, since you respect, all respect, sure, fine. It's exactly what the Pharisees and the Herodians and all these people that normally are on either side of the coin. The Pharisees and the Herodians often don't see eye to eye on a lot of things. And yet, here they are working together to try and figure out, okay, a direct attack is not going to work. Let's try a softer approach. A more gentle approach. Play into the ego a little bit. Oh, you're a great teacher. Oh, you don't care about a person's social standing. But, so here we see, it's our life. Another great example of this is words are wind. I can stand here. And I can quote chapter and verse. I can point to the teachings of Christ. I can do all of those things if you've got the time. But if I don't live those words when I leave this place, those words mean nothing. They're empty. Our convictions, our actions have to meet our words. I work with high school students. They have a great nose for inauthenticity. Probably you don't believe any of this that you're telling us right now, do you? I do, but I have trouble with it. Yeah, we can tell. You're not as excited, you're not on fire for it as you normally are. You're not as animated. Well, sometimes I have the visitation sisters at 7 o'clock in the morning. And when eighth period comes, it's hard to maintain that level of energy. Who we are, who we're becoming, has to match our words. Has to match our hearts. Again and again, words, they truly are wind. If we don't allow them to enter into us, to transform our hearts, to then go out these doors. Faith and works, they go together. That's the great Paul. Faith and works. And oftentimes, people hear a lot of words and they shut off. I see it more days than not. Again, I'm a teacher. I can tell when my sophomore boys, done. You keep doing your thing. I'm just going to do whatever. I can guarantee all of you have done that at some point this week. I know I have. But when somebody truly believes and actually allows their life to show that, their actions to show that, oh, you can't help but take notice of that. You can't help but be drawn to that. This is why we need to live lives of hope, peace, understanding, contentment, welcoming, opening our hearts to others to draw them to this place, to these words. Because when the two work together, it is amazing what happens. The transformation that occurs inside of us, the transformation that can occur in others. So let's not allow ourselves to be a people who use but, comma, truth. Let's let the whole thing be truth. Let's let our minds, our words, and our actions be true across the board. And not just speak a really good game, but when no one's watching, no one's watching. May God be blessed. So let's stand now and profess our shared and common faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. And on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Turning now in confidence and love, we bring our prayers and our petitions for ourselves, our community, and our whole world.
For the Church, that we with Pope Francis and our clergy recognize God's work in the world today and see God as the ultimate source of all that we are, we pray to the Lord. For elected leaders, that they are cognizant of the privilege they have to hold their positions of power, that they may use that position for the betterment of those they serve, we pray to the Lord. For respect in our world for all human life, from conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord. For the vulnerable, especially for children, teens, and young women suffering abuse or exploitation, may they receive help and hope through our continued prayers, we pray to the Lord. For those affected by disease or illness, their families, their caregivers, we pray to the Lord. For the parishioners of St. Patrick's Church, especially Felix and Francis Sajewski, Fred Hank, Patricia Rogalski, for whom this Mass is being offered, may they rest in the peace of Christ, Pray to the Lord.
God, our Heavenly Father, you know us and you love us. Hear our prayers and answer them according to your will. Change our hearts and our minds so that they match your will. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state. And by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with a company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, our sister church, Immaculate Conception, St. Francis de Sales, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
To the kingdom, power, and the glory of yours now.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Share now a sign of God's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord. Does not appear to be any announcements. Grab a bulletin or check online, either one, to find out what's happening here at the parish. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads for God's blessing. May the road rise to meet you. May the winds be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and the rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may God bless all of you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And you, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast down to hell Satan and the other evil spirits who prowl through the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. Thank you for joining us today at Historic Church of St. Patrick. We hope to see you again soon.